Harris Ace Hardware, West Cherry Street in Jessup.
It's time now for the latest in local sports and sports. We've got Monday Night Football here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5. The Falcons currently holding on to that final playoff spot in the NFC picture. Need to win tonight at Tampa, win their final two games against the Saints and Panthers, have a chance to still win the division. Falcons played in last year's Super Bowl, still have their sights on this year's Super Bowl. Again, it all starts tonight. Need to win in Tampa, kickoff 8:30. We'll have it all for you right here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5. Jacksonville Jaguars close out their home schedule with a whipping of the Texans 45-7 in the playoffs for the first time since 2007. And Jaguars, the number three seed at the moment in the AFC playoff picture. Defense playing well. Blake Bortles playing extremely well the last several weeks. Jaguars at San Francisco on Christmas Eve. Elsewhere, the Bills beat the Dolphins 24-16. Buffalo in the playoff picture at this point. The Panthers beat the Packers 31-24. Carolina in the playoffs at this point. Ravens over Cleveland 27-10. On the outside looking in, still with a chance to make the playoffs. The Browns are still winless. Vikings in the playoffs. They beat the Bengals 34-7. Bengals announcing head coach Marvin Lewis will step down at the end of the season. Saints beat the Jets 31-19. Eagles over the Giants 34-29. Redskins beat the Cardinals 20-15. Rams whip up on the Seahawks 42-7 at Seattle. Todd Gurley, a big day for the Rams. Niners beat the Titans 25-23. Patriots on a controversial call at the end beat Pittsburgh 27-24. And last night, the Cowboys kept their playoff hopes alive, beat the Raiders 20-17. Again tonight, Monday Night Football, Atlanta at Tampa, 8:30 kickoff. It all begins right here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5 with the pregame show. Varsity basketball teams hosted Toombs County Friday night at the Benny Ratliff Arena. Both the varsity boys and girls teams win. The boys' final was Wayne County 56, Toombs County 36. Three players in double digits for Wayne County, led by Anthony Grant's 12. Jamar Taylor and Amari Harris each had 10. Boys and girls at Dodge County Tuesday. Then the boys play Valdosta Saturday at the Phillips Arena in Atlanta. That's a boys' game only this Saturday. Varsity girls improved to 8-1. Alex Thomas had a big night. 31 to lead the way for Wayne County. They win easily 46-17. Now they head to Dodge County on Tuesday to play the team that only beat them this season. Again, Dodge County girls pretty good, but again, a rematch on Tuesday at Dodge County. Wayne County back on November 20th, or that's when they lost, back on November 25th. Lady Jack is looking to even the score Tuesday at Dodge. Again, the girls game at 6 Tuesday, the boys game at 7:30. High school finals took place over the weekend. And 7A was North Gwinnett, defeating Colquitt 19-17 on a last-second field goal. And 6A, Lee County beat Coffee in overtime 28-21. Single A, Clinch beat Irwin 21-12. And 5A was Rome all over Warner Robins 38-0. Blessed Trinity in the 4A final defeats Mayor 16-7. And Hatfield Charter defeats Rabun County 35-23 in the AA final. Signing day this Wednesday all across the state of Georgia. It's early this year, normally not till February. The coach is getting ready for bowl season and hot on the recruiting trail. Over the weekend, Georgia commit running back James Cook took an unexpected visit to Florida State. Cook, the younger brother, is Seminole star running back Dalvin Cook. Time will tell where he signs. Georgia's recruiting class right now currently ranked third nationwide behind only Ohio State and Texas. In the bowl action, picks back up on Tuesday. Again, Florida Atlantic and Akron tomorrow night. Again, there were six bowl games played over the weekend. And again, the bowl action will pick back up on this coming Tuesday as they have the bowl between Boca Raton bowl between Akron and Florida Atlantic. That's going to do it for the latest in local sports. Sports is